Good morning, girls. So this is the PPT for the novel Stone Angel by Margaret Lawrence. Margaret Lawrence is a popular Canadian writer. She's a feminist. Full name is Jean Margaret Lawrence, a major figure in Canadian literature. So you can see the major points that are written here. She used the pen name Steve Lancaster. Speaking about the novel was published in 1964. It is one of a series of five novels. Actually, the speciality of all these five novels is that all these five novels are set in the fictional town of Manawaka, which is located in Canada. So the fictitious town of Manawaka is the setting, and the time is in the early 1960s. It's a first person narrative by Hagar Shipley. Hagar Shipley is our main character. One major aspect of the novel is that it alternates between the past and the present. There is a total of 10 chapters in the novel. You find two narrative arcs because, as I told you, there is an intermingling, a blending of past and present. So Hagar tells us the story from her present situation when she's an old woman. She's a 90-year-old woman, and also she reminisces and she has memories about her past, of her childhood and of her marriage to Bram. Another thing to note about the novel is that it was in the year 2007, a film adaptation was also released in the same name, Stone Angel, by Carrie Skoglund. Now, moving on to the plot of the novel, I just noted down important aspects here, so I'll just give you a brief summary of what happens. When the novel begins, she's a 90-year-old woman. She's struggling because she's very sick. She has arthritis and other gastrointestinal problems, and she's living with her son Marvin and his wife Doris. But she finds out that Marvin and Doris intend to send her to an old age home, a nursing home. So she's struggling with that. She does not want to go to the nursing home because for her, the nursing home represents death. So she does not want to go, and she has this memory lapses. That is, she thinks she has this memory about her past, and she's saying how she was living, how her mother died at childbirth. So she did not have a mother. And her father was very, what can we say, a very unemotional kind of person, very strict. And she had two brothers, Dan and Matt. She's reminiscing how her brother Dan is dying of a pneumonia. And Matt had tried to convince her to put on a shawl and pretend to be the mother so that Dan would get some comfort in his dying moments. But she denies this request. Because she can't imagine trying to be someone else. So she had this pride in her from her starting itself. And also we find that she's trying to defy her father, and she married Bram. Bram actually was a very attractive kind of person, but much older, and he came from a lower class. So her father did not approve. So she defied her father and married Bram, and thus she was cut off from all inheritance. And marriage with Bram was not a very happy one. They had this communication gap, and Bram did not fully accept her. She sometimes felt very ashamed of Bram because he was a lower class and because of his mannerisms. She had two sons, John and Marvin. Marvin was the eldest, John was the youngest. She showed favoritism towards the youngest son, John. And when Marvin goes to the war, goes off to World War I, he goes to fight in World War I, and she leaves her husband and separates from her husband Bram and leaves with John, her younger son. But going away after separating from Bram and living with John, it was not a very happy occasion. She had to work as a housekeeper at a person's house. But she was struggling, but the Great Depression hit and they could not save money as she had thought. And John goes back to his father, and later we find that Bram dies. And when she hears that Bram is very sick, she goes to him to take care of him in his final dying days. So after the death of Bram, we find that Hagar tries to stay on with John for a little while. But John resents his mother, and he and his girlfriend Arlene I had an accident, and in that accident you find the both John and his girlfriend dies. Here we find that Hagar cannot cry for John. She has an inability to cry. She can't express her emotions. So this is when she compares herself to a stone angel. The stone angel was a statue, a blind stone sculpture that was kept in the cemetery. So she compares herself to that stone angel because she thinks she can't express her emotions. Now coming to the present. So this past and present is intermingling. So actually in the coming back to the present, she's living with her son Marvin and Doris. She fears being sent to the nursing home. So one day she escapes. She takes some money and she goes to the woods, to a particular place called Shadow Point. There she finds an abandoned cannery or a kind of an abandoned house. And she spends the night there. You have to imagine that she is a 90-year-old woman, very sick and very old. But there she finds another wanderer, Murray Lees, who is a stranger, who also comes and stays in the abandoned cannery. And she opens up to him. She tells him her sorrows and about her life. And then she sleeps. When she's sleeping, Murray Lees slowly escapes and he brings help. Because he understood that she was an old lady and she was very sick and all. So Murray Lees brings her son Marvin and the police there. So she is rescued and then taken to the hospital. So this dying year, this last year, these last moments in her life, she is able to reconcile herself with Marvin. And she confesses to Marvin that Marvin is actually the better son. She had been a good son to her, etc. And she's also able to build up some comforting relationships with the other inmates in the hospital. So in the end, in the climax, it's not clear whether she dies or not. But anyway, her end is imminent. So that is all there is to plot. Now here we have the major characters. Hagar Shipley in the center. She is the major character. Hagar Shipley can be called an anti-heroine. Because given her antagonistic behavior towards everyone else, she behaves very because she is not able to express herself emotionally or in a very good way with her brother and her father, and even with her relationship with her husband and her sons were also not very good. And we find her husband here, Brampton Bram Shipley. Her father is Jason Curry. She had two sons, Marvin and John Shipley. Her daughter-in-law is Doris. And there are other minor characters also, like Arlene, the love interest of John Shipley. There is a minister and many other small characters. So next, moving on to the important themes, we have womanhood, memory and past, family, love and resentment, choices and identity. And there are also this danger of pride. Hagar's quality that brings her downfall or is her pride, because she's not able to let go of her pride and accept others. Her trying to control others, how she was resisting control throughout her life, trying resisting control by her husband, her father, and later by her husband, later by her sons, and the aspect of growing old, suppression of emotions, and womanhood is a very important theme. How Hagar is not an epitome of womanhood. She's not able to accept the womanhood roles like being a good daughter, a good husband, a good mother, etc. One major reason for that might be that she did not have a mother. She was brought up by a housekeeper who was called Auntie Doll. Okay. And duty is also another theme in the novel. So this is all we have to know about the novel. And I hope you could well understand it. And thank you.